What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about upgrading to Windows 11 22H2 using a Configuration Manager task sequence. So let's get right into that. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is open up your Configuration Manager. We're going to go inside Software, Overview, and within Overview, we're going to open up Operating Systems. And within Operating Systems, we're going to go inside Operating Systems Upgrade Packages. Okay, now, hopefully you already imported a Windows 11 build 22H2 within the operating system image node. Should be able to do that. If not, check out my channel. I have created other videos on showing you how to import an operating system into SCCM. But for this video, I'm not going to show you how to import an image. I'm just going to go straight inside the operating system upgrade package. We're going to right-click on that. We're going to pick on Add Operating System Upgrade Package. And you're going to get this. Now I'm going to click on Browse, and I'm going to go into the location of where my Windows 11 22H2 image source files are located. So this is the root folder, and I'm going to select that folder. Okay. The next thing that you need to do is check off by checking this box, you're agreeing that when applying the operating system to a device, either one, blah, 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 just check that off and then click on Next. We're going to click on the drop-down menu. We're going to pick our language. For me, it's English, right? You're going to pick your flavor, 86 or 64-bit. I'm going to pick 64. Click Next here. I'm going to provide it a name. This is what I gave it. Pretty simple. Upgrade to Windows 11, X64, version 2H22. Now, don't yell at me. Yes, I made a typo. I've been doing this a lot. For some reason, 22H2. In my mind was like 2H22. I don't know where the hell I got this from, but I was just stuck in calling this build 2H22. It's supposed to be 22H2. Ah, I know. Once you give it a name, click Next. You're going to get a nice little summary. Click Next. Green check mark. It's always a good thing when you get a green check mark within your configuration manager. We're going to click on Close. We're going to select our upgrade package. We're going to right click on it, and we're going to pick on distribute content. Once you get the distribute content wizard, click Next here. We're going to click on Add. We're going to pick on DP. We're going to pick our DP. We're going to click OK, and then we're going to click on Next, which gives us a nice little summary. Click Next again, green check mark, always a good thing, and then close it. Now, on your right-hand side on the content status, make sure that you got your package selected, and make sure it turns green. Once it turns green, for me, I like when it turns green because then that allows me to continue. It's like go. Green, go, go, do the next step. So the next step is let's go inside task sequence. And we're going to right click on the task sequence and then pick on create task sequence. From this menu, we're going to select upgrade an operating system from an upgrade package. We just created an upgrade package, so that's what we're doing. Yes. So let's click on next. We're going to give our task sequence a name. I gave it the following. Click next again. For the upgrade package, we are going to click on Browse and then select our package, right? Select it, click OK, good to go. Click Next here. For updates, I'm not going to install any updates, so click Next. For applications, I'm not going to install any apps, so click Next. A summary, Next, green check mark again is always a good thing when you get a green check mark within Configuration Manager, so click on Close. Now, the final thing that we need to do is we are going to right click on it and we are going to pick on deploy. Now, once you pick on deploy, you're going to get the deploy software wizard and we need to select a collection. So I'm going to select browse and you get this nice little warning. So just click OK and we're going to pick our collection. For this example, I'm going to pick on Windows 10 and we are going to click on OK. Once you select your collection, we're going to click on next. For the deployment type, I'm going to leave everything as the default, and we're going to click on Next here. For scheduling, default, click Next. For the user experience, default, click Next. For alerts, don't need any alerts, click Next here. For the DP, left everything as the default, click Next. A nice little summary, click Next. Green check marks, and then we are going to close it. Now, on a Windows 10 machine, if you locate the Software Center and you go inside Operating Systems, you're going to see that you have that deployment, upgrade to Windows 11, version 22H2, not 2H22, Bernardo. Ah, I don't know why. If you select it and you just follow the prompts, install, it's going to reboot. It's going to upgrade it with no problem. Now, I did have some issues, and it was not the deployment. The problem is because Windows 11 has these crazy requirements with you have to have a certain version of TPM. You have to have like secure boots and all this other crap configured before you deploy Windows 11. And my virtual environment wasn't set up to deploy it, so I've had some problems with that part. But the deployment should work with no problem. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.